What is frontotemporal dementia?
Animation of a young, middle-aged, and older adult standing together. The focus moves to the middle-aged adult.
Frontotemporal dementia, or FTD, is a rare form of dementia that tends to occur at a younger age than other forms of dementia.
A line of 10 people changes to 6.
About 60% of people with FTD are diagnosed between the ages of 45 and 64.
A side view of a brain shows labels on the frontal lobe, which is near the forehead, and temporal lobes, which are in the middle of the brain near the ears.
FTD and related disorders gradually damage the brain's frontal and temporal lobes. The frontal and temporal lobes in the brain are involved in behavior, movement, language, and emotion. In FTD, nerve cells in these lobes stop working properly. Symptoms of FTD vary from person to person and may include changes in personality and behavior, difficulty moving, and trouble communicating. As the disease progresses, symptoms get worse and new symptoms may appear. The three main types of frontotemporal disorders are behavioral variant frontotemporal dementia, FTD-related movement disorders, and primary progressive aphasia.
A person attempts to fold a piece of paper and tries to fit it into an envelope but is unable to do so. The person bangs their hands on the table in frustration.
Behavioral variant FTD causes changes in personality, behavior, and judgment. A person may have problems doing tasks with multiple steps and may become frustrated, act inappropriately, or become disinterested in people and activities they used to care about.
A person with shaky hands is unable to successfully use a fork to eat their meal.
People with movement disorders related to FTD may walk more slowly or stiffly, have shaky hands, or be unable to make common motions, such as using a fork.
Two older adult men walk next to a lake. One of the men looks at a sign, is unable to read it, and is confused.
Primary progressive aphasia is a type of frontotemporal disorder that makes it difficult to use language. A person may lose their ability to speak, read, write, or understand what others are saying.
A scientist uses a microscope to look at a sample containing nerve cells, which are also shown on a monitor.
Scientists are still studying what causes FTD. People with the disease have abnormal amounts of tau and TDP43 proteins inside nerve cells in their brain. In most cases, the cause of this buildup is unknown. However, changes in genes may also lead to FTD.
The monitor transitions to a photo of a family of four standing together.
People with a family history of FTD are more likely to have a genetic form of the disease.
The woman from the photo talks with her doctor. The doctor shows her a computer screen showing a side view of a brain with the frontal and temporal lobes labeled.
FTD can be hard to diagnose because symptoms are similar to other conditions. If you have a family history of FTD or are experiencing changes in personality, behavior, or movement, talk with a doctor. While there is no cure, there may be ways to help manage the symptoms.
Logo for NIH, National Institute on Aging.
To learn more about frontotemporal dementia, visit alzheimers.gov/FTD.